In this video, you'll learn how to simulate a KUKA robot in iiQWorks.Sim using the RCS module, while externally wiring the robot inputs via the Open Platform Communication Unified Architecture (OPC UA). To do this, we'll use the iiQWorks.Sim connectivity add-on. Make sure this add-on is activated. You can check this by going to File, then Options, and under Add-ons, enable the slider for the connectivity add-on. Once activated, a new tab called Connectivity will appear at the top. Inside this tab, you'll find four different interfaces. In this example, we'll use the OPC UA interface to connect to Codesys. In Codesys, we've already prepared a small program. Now let's switch back to iiQWorks.Sim. In our simulation, we have a KR10R1100 robot positioned in front of four colored cubes. In the config.dev file, we've defined a global signal called colorNum. This signal is mapped to inputs 120 through 135. Which gives us 16 bits, enough to represent an integer value. Depending on the value of colorNum, the robot will execute a switch case statement in the main program. For example, if colorNum is 10, the robot picks the blue cube and sets output 103 to true. If colorNum is 20, it picks the yellow cube and sets output 104 to true. If colorNum is 30, it picks the red cube and sets output 105 to true. For any other value, it defaults to picking the green cube and sets output 106 to true. We also have a loop in place that continuously checks for a rising edge on input 119. Only when this edge is detected, the switch case logic is executed. The robot in our simulation is equipped with a jaw gripper. This gripper is also wired through input and output signals. Let's take a look at the signal configuration. Input 101 is true when the gripper is open. Input 102 is true when the gripper is closed. When output 101 is set to true, the gripper opens. When output 102 becomes true, the gripper closes. Now let's switch to the connectivity tab in iiQWorks.Sim. We'll establish a connection to our OPC UA server running in Codesys. To do this, we add a new server and edit the connection settings. Here, you need to enter the server address. In our case, it's localhost and we're using port 4845. Click on Test Connection to verify the setup. If the connection succeeds, click Apply to activate the server. Once applied, the connection is established. You'll now see two sections under the server, Simulation to Server for data going from iiQWorks.Sim to Codesys. Server to Simulation for data coming from Codesys to iiQWorks.Sim. Since we want to simulate robot inputs, we'll use Server to Simulation. Right-click on it and choose Add Variables. A new window called Create Variable Pairs will open. This shows the folder structure of your OPC UA server. Expand the folders, Resources, Application, Programs. Here you'll find all the variables available in your Codesys project. Now you just need to match these variables with the signals used in your simulation project. In the Create Variable Pairs window, I've ticked the boxes for inputs and outputs, as well as degrees of freedom, but we'll come back to that later. Now, let's click on our robot model and open the input signal list. We're going to start with input 119, which is our trigger signal. I've already created a trigger bit variable in Codesys. After selecting and pairing it with the button pair selected, you'll see the connection status at the bottom. It shows the signals are now connected. Next, we need to map the variables for our global signal colorNum. This part is important. We cannot combine multiple robot inputs into a single integer variable on the simulation side. Instead, we need to split the integer variable from Codesys into individual bits and map each bit to a separate input signal in iiQWorks.Sim. So we'll map inputs 120 through 135, 16 bits in total, between the robot and Codesys. Click Pair selected to link multiple variables. But be careful, the order of the bits matters for the binary value. If the mapping is incorrect, the binary value won't be interpreted properly. Here's an example of a wrong mapping. Input 120 might be paired with bit 12 of the Codesys variable, which is incorrect. To fix this, click Unpair and manually pair each signal one by one using Pair Selected. Go through each signal carefully until all 16 bits are correctly mapped. Now we're done with the input setup. Input 119 is connected as the trigger signal, and inputs 120 to 135 are mapped to the bits of our global signal colorNum. Now that we finish mapping the inputs, let's move on to the robot's outputs. These are the signals that will be sent from the simulation to your external software. Open the output signal list of the robot. Earlier, we saw that outputs 101 to 106 are used. Output 101 is for opening the gripper. Output 102 is for closing the gripper. Outputs 103 to 106 are used to indicate which color cube is being picked. 103 corresponds to the blue box, 104 to the yellow box, 105 is the red box, and output 106 is set while the green box is picked. We'll now map these outputs to variables and codices using the same Create Variable Pairs window. Once paired, you'll see the connected variables listed at the bottom of the window. Now let's switch back to codices. Resize the window so you can clearly see the variable list at the top. We're ready to test the setup. Start the simulation in iiQWorks.Sim. You'll see a checkmark next to each variable, confirming that the connection is successful. Let's test the signal flow. In codices, enter the integer value 10 into the variable that's linked to color_num. This value will be split into binary and sent to the robot inputs. Now set the trigger bit to true. The robot should respond by picking the blue cube and setting output 103 to true. Next, enter the value 20, reset the trigger to false, then set it to true again. The robot will pick the yellow cube and activate output 104. Repeat the process with value 30. The robot will pick the red cube and set output 105 to true. Finally, enter a value like 99, which doesn't match any predefined case. The robot will default to picking the green cube and set output 106 to true. This confirms that the entire signal flow, from codices to iiQWorks.Sim and back, is working correctly. Besides inputs and outputs, you can also transmit simulation values like robot axis positions. These are typically of the data type real and can be read directly from the simulation model. We'll use the iiQWorks.Sim connectivity add-on to link these values. To do this, we need to set the data direction from the simulation to the server. Go to Add Variables again. This time, we don't need the signal maps, so you can hide them. Instead, we'll focus on the robot's behavior values. Open the KRC5 folder, and under Value, you'll find the robot axis values. In this example, I've already prepared variables and codices to receive the current robot axis values. Now select each axis, Robot Axis 1, Robot Axis 2, Robot Axis 3, Robot Axis 4, Robot Axis 5, Robot Axis 6. Click Pair selected for each one. Once all six axes are paired, you'll see the connections listed at the bottom. Start the simulation again. Then open codices, and you'll see the current axis values being updated in real time. To test the setup, enter a value like 10 into the color_num variable, reset the trigger to false, and then set it to true. You'll see the robot move, and the axis values will update accordingly. This confirms that the robot's live position data is being transmitted correctly from iiQWorks.Sim to codices. To finish up, let's take a look at a really useful feature in the connectivity add-on, exporting and importing your I/O configuration. You can export your current I/O mapping to a file, for example, to your desktop. Then, even if you remove all connections, you can simply import the saved configuration file to restore everything with just a few clicks. Just make sure your OPC UA server is running. Once you activate the connection again, all variables are reconnected, and you'll see the green check marks confirming everything is working. In this video, you learned how to simulate a KUKA robot in iiQWorks.Sim using the RCS module and connect it to codices via OPC UA. We mapped input and output signals, transferred real-time axis values, and validated the robot's behavior using trigger signals and case logic. Finally, we showed how to export and import the I/O configuration to quickly restore your setup with just a few clicks.
Thank you for watching. We hope you find this video tutorial helpful. Don't forget to follow the KUKA channel for more updates and more exciting content. If you're looking for hands-on training, visit the KUKA College to enhance your skills. See you in the next video.
making automation easier.